Hello guys, welcome to ZenAD channel. Okay, in this channel we will talk all about Chronos Zen on PC using mouse and keyboard. Okay, today's video we'll talk about info that is 8 important things about Chronos Zen on PC in this new game. Okay, this is the updated version. Okay, updated video. I will show you here 8 important info about Chronos Zen when you are using this device, okay, especially on PC using mouse and keyboard. Okay, but before we are going into the video, please give a like, subscribe, and turn on bell notification so when upload new video you will get notified. Okay, in this channel we upload video all about Chronos Zen on PC. Okay, without further ado, let's start the video. Okay, now we are in the video. For start, I will show you here in the screen. The first important info is on the output protocol. Okay, open your Zen Studio, go to the device tab. In here, emulator output protocol change to Xbox 360. This is very important, okay? Some people or even in the Chronos Zen official, when you are using Chronos Zen on PC, they are told you are change to auto, okay, but I'm using this device, okay, just three years, okay. The only protocol I'm using is Xbox 360, okay. This is the best protocol, okay. If I'm using the other protocol, it cannot work, especially on this gamepad tester, okay. We only need this emulator output protocol to Xbox. We only need to change the emulator output protocol to Xbox 360. Okay. But if this not working to you, just try the auto. But all my viewers and that contact me, it's all working when they are using this emulator output protocol Xbox 360. Okay. That's the number one. Next, the number two. Okay. This is very common in the problem on the Chronos Zen. Unplug the plug unplug method, okay. I will show you here. Sorry, I'll unplug this all this mouse and keyboard, plug the mouse and plug the keyboard. You can see just the mouse is working, we don't have the keyboard. So just unplug the mouse and plug it again. That's simple. Now all mouse and keyboard is working. That is the second important thing, unplug and plug mouse method. Next, the mouse. Okay, you need high DPM mouse to use it on Chronos Zen. Okay, I made the video, you can use the low DPM mouse, but you have to crank up the or add the sensitivity. But it's not helping because the sensitivity is just, you can get the input lag, okay? So I highly recommended using high DPM mouse. The mouse right now is fairly cheap, okay? I only get this around $30, $30 USD, okay. So number three in this important things is the mouse. Use high DPM mouse, okay. Next, number four, supported mouse and keyboard. Okay, I already mentioned in the my previous video about mouse and keyboard, okay. You can use any mouse and keyboard, okay. This is my previous mouse, okay. This is the Rexus DAX 1 and this is Vortex Series Inno X2. Okay, all detected and working on the Chronos Zen. But you can see here on the device tab, keyboard and mouse is question mark. Okay, but it's all good. Next, the number five, controller. You can see here controller. If you have any controller that connected to your Chronos Zen, you can see here. Sorry, It's not the in here. This is our my ChronoSense, okay? Let's say I'm connecting this on my PC. My ChronoSense is on the player 2 or player 3, but on player 1 we have the controller. You have to unplug your controller first to use this ChronoSense. If not, the game will detect your controller, not the ChronoSense. So make sure you unplug all the controller that connected to your PC. Next, number 6, dead zone. Okay, we don't need any dead zone. You can see here in the Sense settings, Sense Studio settings. Okay, we don't need any dead zone compensation on mouse and keyboard on ChronoSense. Okay, because we don't have any drifting when we are using mouse. When you put the mouse, you can get any drifting. Okay, especially on the gaming mouse. And then on the controller, controller dead zone here, we don't need any dead zone compensation. Okay, so put it one. Next time I will try the 0. So the number 6 important thing is we don't need any dead zone on mouse and keyboard users. Okay, next, sensitivity. This is important one. Okay, remember this is low for ChronoSense users. On ChronoSense site you have to use the 20, but for me 7 is enough. Okay, because I'm using this high DPO mouse, we don't need any high sensitivity on in game and on the Sense Studio. Okay, sorry, in here sensitivity 55, this is enough for me because I'm using 20,000 DPI on this mouse. So I really prefer high DPI mouse, low sensitivity between rather than low DPI mouse with high sensitivity. So lowering down your sensitivity in game and Sense Studio and get the high DPI mouse. Next, number 8, this is the most important thing when you are using ChronoSense. All scripts are free. Remember, all scripts free. This is important, okay? You can go to the Taylor Dev scripts, server Discord server. You can get any scripts in here. Even you can get the support, okay, and then the download section. This is ProIM, Modern Trilite, Fit Download, Sicario Download, Orion Download, Nusbar Scripts. Okay, you can get all these scripts. Even you can get in game pack in the programmer tab in the Sense Studio. Even though you can get the library. Okay, so do not buy any scripts. In others video, I will give you make a video about paid scripts. Okay, there are just scam. Okay, I will make another video about the paid scripts later if I have time. Okay, but for now, please do not buy any scripts. They are just scams. Just use the free scripts from the library here or game pack from the programmer tab, or the best things you can get free on the Taylor Rift Discord server. Okay, I think it's all for this video or for all important thing on ChronoSense. If you have any question, please ask in comment section and don't forget to give a like and subscribe to the channel. And in the end of this video, I will give you some clips using there are no gun in here. Sorry, it's just my habit. Okay, thanks for watching and see you in the next video.